As Donald Trump's second impeachment trial nears, there is one senator who led the charge to challenge the Electoral College count and enthusiastically threw his weight behind multiple efforts to undermine the Democratic presidential election and is now trying to cleanse himself of the stain of those actions.
President Trump's rhetoric, I think, went way too far over the line. I think it was both reckless and irresponsible, because he said repeatedly, and he said over and over again, he won by a landslide. There was massive fraud. It was all stolen everywhere.
Texas Republican Senator Ted Cruz now says Donald Trump crossed a line. But before insurrectionists attacked the Capitol in a deadly siege that cost at least one Capitol Hill police officer his life, Cruz didn't seem to mind the, quote, reckless and irresponsible rhetoric from the president. In fact, Cruz joined in, speaking to voters in Georgia in early January, just days before the Senate runoffs there.
I am inspired. Each of you look around, the men and women that are gathered here, you are patriots, just like the patriots gathered at Bunker Hill, just like the patriots gathered at Valley Forge, just like the patriots who forged this nation. The men and women gathered here and across the state of Georgia are fighting for the United States of America.
Fighting for the United States of America. I know it sounds familiar because we also heard that rhetoric a few days later on January 6th, right before Trump supporters tried to pay Ted Cruz and his colleagues a visit with flexicuffs.
And we fight. We fight like hell. And if you don't fight like hell, you're not going to have a country anymore.
Cruz, on his recent revisionist history tour, went on to criticize Planet Trump for failing to produce evidence of these baseless accusations of a stolen election.
That evidence, the campaign did not prove that in any court.
Right.
And to make a determination about an election, it has to be based on the evidence. And so simply saying the result you want, that's not responsible. And you've never heard me use language like that.
Right.
Never heard him use language like that, he says. Well, remember, this is Senator Cruz, who signed on to a Texas lawsuit that challenged the election results in Georgia, Pennsylvania, Michigan, and Wisconsin. Senator Cruz, who former President Trump wanted to front the lawsuit before the Supreme Court, if it had ever made it before the justices. It didn't, of course, because the court tossed it out. This Senator Cruz calling out Planet Trump for baseless claims when he was very much aware of the long list of court cases that the Trump team or his allies lost or dropped between November 4th and January 6th, the day of the insurrection, when he stood on the Senate floor and still challenged the election result in Arizona.
But for those who respect the voters, simply telling the voters, go jump in a lake, the fact that you have deep concerns is of no moment to us. That jeopardizes, I believe, the legitimacy of this and subsequent elections.
For this, he lost his communications director, who reportedly resigned over his act. And by the way, I do want to address the question that you were no doubt asking, which is, what's up with this random show featuring a sitting U.S. senator in a lounge chair?
Welcome back to Verdict with Ted Cruz.
Let me say to all our viewers, it's good to be back with you.
So this is a podcast shown on YouTube that Cruz started up during Trump's first impeachment trial. It's complete with those fancy graphics. There's a floating monitor, a carpet square. There's a cactus, and it rocks a leather chair Masterpiece Theater style. And like Masterpiece Theater, Cruz's podcasts include adaptations of fiction. In this recent episode, Cruz tries to absolve himself of his participation in the big lie. His performance of ridding himself of the stink and stain of it appears to be a very loose adaptation of Lady Macbeth, saying, out damn spot. And in another clip, he makes reference to more contemporary works like Avengers Endgame and Watchmen, the comic book-based hit series.
Have you noticed in how many movies, how often rabid environmentalists are the bad guys? Whether it's Thanos or go to Watchmen, you know, where the view of the left is people are a disease.
That reference prompting a writer and producer of the show Watchmen to tweet at the senator, quote, literally, "What the bleep are you talking about?" which is also an acceptable response to another comment that Cruz, with the help of those armrests, made on his podcast.
Reuters polling shows 39% of Americans believe the election was rigged. That's a terrifying statistic.
Says a guy who spoon-fed Trump supporters the big lie, who helped dig a hole only to marvel curiously at how deep and dark it is as he stares up at us from the bottom of it, insisting he's not in a hole at all, because Cruz's masterpiece theater rewrite of history is just that, theater.